Colon cancer is one of the most common forms of cancer. It's also one of the deadliest, but it's often one that we might forget about. This morning we're talking with Dr. Jeffrey Lisko. He is a gastroenterologist. Thank you so much for coming in. We want to talk about raising awareness because you guys are doing something this weekend to do that. But first, let's talk about colon cancer. And you said it's becoming more common, more diagnosed. Right.
The incidence of colorectal cancer is going up in the United States.
Do we know why?
We do not know why. That's the billion-dollar question.
Mm-hmm.
Whether it's diet, sedentary lifestyle, we're not sure. But the incidence in patients under the age of 40 is going up dramatically.
Really? So it's a cancer that maybe we often thought was older?
Exactly.
We're seeing in younger men then?
Yes. Now, to date myself, going back to medical school 20 years ago, it was considered a diagnosis or a disease of older patients,
right.
You know, over the age of 50. And it's a big paradigm shift now for us as gastroenterologists and primary care doctors that we are seeing it, you know, crop up in patients under the age of 40. We've seen patients in their 30s.
Wow.
The United Kingdom's had an incidence surge of about 125% in patients under the age
wow.
of 30. And it affects men and women equally.
Let's talk about it because it's becoming more common. Yet it's very easy, like the test, to detect and then treat, right?
Yeah, I think the horror story that people have is the colonoscopy
oh,
itself.
Oh, yeah, of course. You hear about it and you don't want to do it,
yes.
But it's not that difficult.
The prep is a lot better than it used to be mm-hmm. 10, 15 years ago. The procedure itself, if it's done right, really should be painless.
Mm-hmm.
We use sedation for that. People tend to tolerate it very well.
And it's fairly quick, too. I mean, it doesn't take that long.
It doesn't take as long as people would think. I mean, the procedure itself, we allow about a half an hour from start to finish.
What are you recommending, then, if we're seeing this in younger patients? What is the age that you're saying, okay, folks, come in and start talking with your doctors about this and getting a
right.
test?
Well, the guidelines were at age 50, unless you had a first-degree relative with a history mm-hmm. of colorectal cancer or polyps under the age of 60, then mm-hmm. we'd recommend starting at age 40. But I think the message to get out to the viewers is that if you're having symptoms and you know your body better than anyone else,
mm-hmm.
you know, you walk
mm-hmm.
into an office and the doctor has all these diplomas on the wall, you still know your body better than anyone else and you need to be an advocate. And if you're having bleeding or symptoms
mm-hmm.
and it doesn't seem right, you know, keep pushing.
Get in there and start asking some questions.
Yep.
Let's talk about an event you guys have coming up tomorrow. Tell
right.
us about that.
Get your rear in gear. It's a... It was an event that was started about 10 years ago,
uh-huh.
actually, to the date. It was started, founded by Minnesota Gastroenterologists, which I'm a group member of, and colorectal surgery associates, or colleagues in
uh-huh.
colorectal surgery. And it's grown. I think there are going to be 40 races now nationwide.
Wow.
And it's really pretty special. I think last year they had close to 5,000 people running, survivors, caregivers. It's really awe-inspiring.
So it's going on tomorrow, and tell us about it. Starts at 7 o'clock?
It starts at 8:30.
There's a
kid fun run.
Okay.
And then followed by a 5K run for the more serious runners, and
okay.
then there's more of a fun run afterwards. You can register when you get there if you haven't registered already.
Okay. So, and we know that it's going to be a great
nice
day
weather.
Out there tomorrow.
Absolutely.
So get out there early, register, get your exercises in, get ready to run or walk or whatever, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
All right. Thank you so much
yeah.
for coming in. We appreciate
Thanks.
That. We've got all of this information and more. You were talking about symptoms, too, and we didn't quite get into that. So more on our website at kstp.com. Just go there and click on links.